When the enemy sets the prayer agenda, when the enemy sets the prayer agenda, amen. Wacha nifanye introduction niseme ya kwamba, so many nations, so many ministries, so many families, and so many individual people, their prayer life agenda is set by the enemy and not by God. Bwana asifiwe sana. Kile Mungu amenifunulia na amenisaidia kuona ni ya kwamba maisha ya mataifa, maisha ya kanisa na jamii na watu wengi, muongozo wao wa maombi sio Mungu hupatiana, ni adui hupatiana. And sometimes Mungu hukubalia adui apatiane muongozo kwa sababu watu wake wamelala. What do I mean by the enemy setting the prayer agenda? I want to simply say that there are so many people who pray when the enemy has hit their lives, has bombarded their lives with sickness, has bombarded their lives with challenges that they are not equal to face. That is when they cry to God. Watu wengi huwa wanamlilia Mungu wakati kumekuja shida za magonjwa, wakati wamefinyiriwa, wakati kumekuwa na maumivu, wakati kumekuwa na mapigo ya adui. Watu wengi huwa wanaamuka wakati huo. Na nitakuonyesha katika Biblia kwamba that is not the will of God. The will of God is not for you to rise up in prayer when the enemy has attacked your life. The will of God is not for you to cry to God when you are oppressed by the enemy. That is not the will of God. We can begin in the book of Judges, chapter 3. Judges, inaitwa Waamuzi, mlango wa tatu. Waamuzi tatu, kuanzia mstari wa saba. The Bible says in Judges, chapter 3, from verse 7, so the children of Israel did evil in the sight of the Lord. They forgot the Lord their God and served the Baal and Asherah. Therefore, the anger of the Lord was hot against Israel, and he sold them into the hand of Cushan-Rishathaim, king of Mesopotamia. And the children of Israel served Cushan-Rishathaim 8 years. When the children of Israel cried out to the Lord raised up a deliverer for the children of Israel who delivered them, Othniel, the son of Kenaz, Caleb's younger brother. The Spirit of the Lord came upon him, and he judged Israel. He went out to war, and the Lord delivered Cushan-Rishathaim, king of Mesopotamia, into his hand. And his hand prevailed over Cushan-Rishathaim. So the land had rest for 40 years. Then Othniel, the son of Kenaz, died. And the children of Israel again did evil in the sight of the Lord. So the Lord strengthened Eglon, king of Moab, against Israel, because they had done evil in the sight of the Lord. Then he gathered to himself the people of Ammon and Amalek, went and defeated Israel, and took possession of the city palms. So the children of Israel served Eglon, king of Moab, 18 years. Last verse, verse 15. But when the children of Israel cried out to the Lord, the Lord raised up a deliverer for them, Ehud, the son of Gera, the Benjamite, a left-handed man. By him, the children of Israel sent tribute to Eglon, king of Moab. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. When you read the Bible in the book of Judges, there is a pattern that you see in the book of Judges. There is a recurring expression used to introduce the cycles of the judges. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. And this cycles is that every time they cried of distress, occurring in every cycle. Praise the name of the living God. So you see, God gives them a judge, delivers them, they backslide, they are oppressed, they cry to God. God gives another judge, they backslide, they cry to God. The cycle was the same. That means their prayer agenda was always set by the enemy. Praise the name of the living God. And you see, the Israelites were a type of the church here on earth. Wao ni mfano wa kanisa hapa duniani. Na Biblia inatufundisha na wao ya kwamba hilo kanisa hakuna wakati waliamka kuomba kabla hawajafinyiriwa na adui. Kabla adui yao hajawashika na kuwatesa hawangeamka. Bwana asifiwe sana. And let me tell you, this pattern is still there in so many people's lives. There are people who never cry to God. There are people who never wake up in prayer until the enemy is in their camp. Until the enemy is oppressing them. You just watch even in the nation. When we are hit by the enemy, maybe so many people have died. Maybe something has happened and has taken away so many lives. That is when people start saying, wacheni tuombe. Watu wa Mungu, wahubiri, kanisa, simuombe taifa. Wakati kuna amani na utulivu, hakuna mtu huongea juu ya maombi. Wakati hakuna shida, hakuna mtu huongea juu ya maombi. And let me tell you, it is unfortunate because it is not in the will of God for us to pray when we are oppressed. But when we sleep and we backslide, God, the Bible says that God would sometimes go to the camp of their enemy and strengthen their enemy so that the enemy would come and oppress them. And when they are oppressed, they cry to God. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. Kwa hivyo ni kumaanisha ya kwamba kuna maadui ambao Mungu alikuwa amewaweka. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. Kuna maadui ambao Mungu alikuwa amewaweka. Na ukisoma katika kitabu hiki cha Judges utaona wakati wana wa Israeli walipoingia katika nchi ya ahadi, kuna wafalme ambao Mungu hakukubali wamalizwe, wafalme maadui zao. Na akasema hawa wacha wakae hapa tu. Hawa ndio nitakuwa ninatumia kuwaamsha wakati mumerara. Ndugu yangu na dada yangu, wakati unarara, kuna maadui tu wako hapo karibu. Wakati mwingine wanakaa kama hawana nguvu. Lakini utakaporara, Mungu atawatia nguvu. Jambo ambalo haungefikiria linaweza kukupata. Linakuja tu. Na linakutesa. Kwa sababu Mungu yuko na haja na wewe ili uamke. Bwana asifiwe sana. What do I want to say? I want to say I refuse for the enemy to set my prayer agenda in Jesus' name. Praise the name of the living God. I will not allow the enemy to set my prayer agenda. I will not wake up in prayer when the enemy is oppressing my life. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. It is unfortunate for people when everything is going on well, they will not wake up in the morning. They will not fast. They forget their prayer closet. Until when the enemy hits their life, that is when they are running everywhere, every prayer mountain, they are trying every kind of fasting. Kwa sababu kansa imewagonga. Magonjwa ya figo yameingia. Shida ambayo hata daktari haelewi imeingia katika maisha yao. Shake up imeingia katika family. Watoto wamekamatwa na madawa ya kulevya na teenage pregnancy. Wakati huo ndio mtu anasema wacha sasa, sasa lazima niombe. Praise the name of the living God. Bidii yako ya maombi inatokana na adui. That's not the will of God. Let me show you the will of God in prayer. In the book of Isaiah, chapter 62. The Bible says, for Isaiah 62 from verse 1, for Zion's sake I will not hold my peace, and for Jerusalem's sake I will not rest until her righteousness goes forth as brightness, and her salvation as a lamp that burns. The Gentiles shall see your righteousness, and all the kings your glory. You shall be called by a new name, which the mouth of the Lord will name. You shall also be a crown of glory in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of your God. You shall no longer be termed forsaken, nor your land anymore be termed desolate, but you shall be called Hezibah, and your land Beulah, for the Lord delights in you, and your land shall be married. For as a young man marries a virgin, so shall your sons marry you. And as the bridegroom rejoices over the bride, so shall your God rejoice over you. I have set watchmen on your walls, O Jerusalem. They shall never hold their peace day or night. You who make mention of the Lord, do not keep silent, and give him no rest till he establishes Jerusalem. Until he makes Jerusalem a praise in the earth. Praise the name of the living God. You see, if you read keenly this portion of scripture in the book of Isaiah, you are going to see God's will in prayer. Amen. In the book of Isaiah, the will of God in prayer is not driven by the enemy. It is driven by God's purpose. It is driven by destiny. It is driven by the will of God for his people. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. And I believe, even when Jesus taught his disciples how to pray, he said, this is how you are supposed to pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done here on earth as it is in heaven. Prayer is supposed to release God's will here on earth. Prayer is supposed to be driven by God's purpose, God's plan, God's agenda for the nation, God's plan for your life. Because the Bible says, I know the plans I have for you. They are not for evil, but for good, to give you a hope and a future. So my prayer should be driven by God's plan for my life. God's purpose for my life. The will of God, if you read this portion of scripture, is establishment. Prayer should be driven by a desire for establishment. Establishment. God to establish our nation in peace, our economy, our families, our career, our businesses, our calling. That should be the source of our prayer drive, that I desire God to establish my life, my family, my career, my calling, my nation, in the name of Jesus. Praise the name of the living God. And so you can see the difference. The difference between people who pray when the enemy is in the camp and the enemy is oppressing them. The enemy has bombarded them. That is when they are everywhere, every mountain, trying every kind of prayer and fasting, looking for every man of God who can pray for them. Na kuna watu wa aina hiyo. Yani ukiwaona wakiomba, kuna shida. But very few are driven to go to the prayer mountain when everything is moving on well in their lives. Why should I go? What am I missing? What am I lacking? Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. My husband still loves me. My children are okay. Praise the name of the living God. Lakini wengine siku ile watasikia kwamba your son ameingia kwa drug. Your daughter amekuwa pregnant. Your husband ameweka another wife. Wakati shida imeingia katika maisha ya watu, ndio wengi huwa wanakimbia katika mlima wa Bwana. Wanasema sasa lazima niamuke. Sasa lazima nikatafute Mungu. Nimekuja nikuambie, hiyo haikuwa mapenzi ya Mungu. Ya kwamba adui ndiye ana set agenda ya maombi katika maisha yako. Hata taifa kama hili utakuta ya kwamba wakati kuna amani na utulivu, tukisema tunaomba, ni kama watu wanakuangalia wanashangaa. Na wewe unasema tunaombea nini? Kwani kuna shida gani? And you see the Bible says, when they shall say peace, peace, sudden destruction shall come upon them. Wakati watu wanasema amani, hakuna shida katika jamii, hakuna shida katika huduma, hakuna shida katika taifa, wakati huo adui ndio ana strike mara moja katika usingizi wetu. Bwana asifiwe sana. Yesu alikuwa anaambia wanafunzi wake, simuombe musije mukaingia katika majaribu. Kwanza wewe Petro, unasema hapa unaweza kukufa na mimi. Unajua adui amepanga kukupepeta kama ngano. Na uko tu hapa na mzaha ya kutoa panga ukate watu masikio. Haujui kile adui amekupangia. Simuombe. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Lakini Petro, ile kilio alilia wakati alianguka, hakulia wakati Yesu anamwambia aombe wakati ana shida. Lakini Yesu mwenyewe aliingia katika dhiki na kulia paka matone, paka jasho yake ikabadilika ikawa damu. Ni heri watu wale wanajua kuingia katika dhiki ya maombi kabla shida haijaingia. And let me tell you, they are very few. Watu wale unaweza kusikia they are groaning. They are interceding fervently. Na hakuna shida katika maisha yao, ni wachache. Watu wengi, when they are groaning because there is pain. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. They are groaning because the enemy is oppressing them. The enemy is in their camp. So who is setting your prayer agenda? It is the enemy. Because you never cry without the enemy oppressing you. You never groan without the enemy oppressing you. And let me tell you, that was what was happening to the children of Israel. Every time you see they cried, it is because they were oppressed. They cried, it is because the enemy was in their camp. Praise the name of the living God. So it was the enemy who was setting their prayer agenda. Wakati unapanga kumtafuta Bwana, ni wakati mateso yamefika katika nyumba yako. Hayo sio mapenzi ya Bwana. Hiyo sio hekima. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. Hallelujah. Mungu anasema nimewaweka walinzi, watchmen, waombezi katika kuta zako wewe Yerusalemu. Hawa walinzi wataona adui akiwa mbali. They shall see the enemy. The watchman will see the enemy before he arrives. And the watchman will raise a war cry. And you say the enemy want to attack before he attacks. Praise the name of the living God. And also the watchmen who are on the wall, they are also watching in the city. What is happening in the city? They are interceding. Praise the name of the living God. The Bible says that they shall never be silent. What a beautiful way of prayer. That I will not be silent. I will not give God rest. Praise the name of the living God. Not because I am not blessed. I am blessed. But I am not established. Praise the name of the living God. Amen. I am blessed, but I have not yet become a praise of praise in all the earth. Bwana asifiwe sana. Hallelujah. Imagine nasema sitanyamaza. Mungu umenibariki jamii, umenibariki biashara, umenibariki huduma, but I want to see establishment. Nataka kufanyika sifa katika mataifa. Bwana asifiwe sana. Huwa tunapapaswa na mabaraka kidogo, Na hizo baraka kidogo zinatutuma katika usingizi. Tunaona kama tumefika. Si Mungu ainue watu walio na maombi kama hayo. Watu ambao wanaomba kwa sababu wanajua kusudi asante Mungu kwa sababu ya mahali nimefika ama mahali tumefika, lakini najua kwamba kusudi lako bado halijatimia. Hapa sio mwisho. Hapa sio mahali ulikusudia nifike. Kwa hivyo sitanyamaza. Jamii yangu there is still higher level. Umenipatia watoto lakini bado hawajamaliza university. Wamemaliza university, hawajaoa na kuolewa. Wameoa lakini jamii zao hazijadhibitika. Bwana asifiwe sana. Nani huyo hatapatia Bwana pumziko paka mwisho aone ya kwamba there is establishment. Aone ya kwamba the church has become a praiser or praiser in all the earth. Hao ndio watu ambao hawatasukumwa na adui kuomba. Hawatatolewa in their comfort zone by the enemy. Why? Because they know the purpose of prayer is destiny. The purpose of prayer is to pursue the will of God. Praise the name of the living God. The purpose of prayer is that the will of God will be done here on earth as it is in heaven. Praise the name of the living God. The purpose of prayer is so that the kingdom of God can come here on earth. Let your kingdom come. I desire to see the manifestation of the kingdom of God. And the Bible tells me the kingdom of God is not a matter of talk, but of power. Hey, don't be silent, my brother. Don't be silent, my sister. In the name of Jesus Christ, kwa sababu tu mambo yanaendelea vizuri, unasema sasa, ninajisumbua na nini? Kwa nini kufunga hizi siku zote? Kuna mtu mgonjwa? Biashara yangu haina shida, jamii haina shida. That's not the purpose of prayer. The purpose of prayer is to see establishment. Is to be made a royal diadem. Praise the name of the living God. Is our righteousness to shine. Praise the name of the living God. That is the will of God. Nani atakuwa muombezi wa aina hii? Muombezi ambaye haombi kama judges. Israel katika kitabu cha Judges. They cried to the Lord. Why? They are oppressed. They cried to the Lord. Why? They are oppressed. For how long are you going to cry when you are oppressed, when the enemy is crushing you? Why can't we learn our lessons as a nation? Why can't we learn our lessons as a church? As a ministry, why can't we learn our lessons in our lives, in our families? For how long are we going to cry when the enemy is crushing us? Praise the name of the living God. That's not the will of God. For you to cry to God when the enemy is crushing you, when the enemy is in your camp, when the enemy is oppressing you, that is when you pray. That is when you desperately cry to God. That's not the will of God. May God raise up people in this church who are going to call upon the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the living God. When everything is running smoothly in your life, but you'll be in the place of prayer, telling God, I desire to see establishment. I desire to see you making the church a place of praise in all the earth. Bwana, ni lini utakapokuja uondoe aibu ya kanisa? Uondoe kudharauliwa na kudunishwa kwa kanisa. Kanisa lako lipate kibali. Tuone wafalme wakija katika nyumba yako, wakikuinamia, wakikulilia kwa sababu ya utukufu na uweza wako. Pokea hiyo neema siku ya leo katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Can somebody tell Lord, I'm not going to cry under the oppression of the enemy. I'll cry for your purposes. I'll cry for your will to be done here on earth as it is in heaven. I will cry for you to make the church a praise of praise in all the earth. In the mighty name of Jesus, I refuse to cry under the oppression, under the yoke of the enemy. I will call upon the name of the Lord
When I am at peace, I'll call upon the name of the Lord. When joy is flowing on my heart, I'll not call upon the name of the Lord because of pain, because of oppression. No, I refuse in the mighty name of Jesus.